Well, Pueblo has been in the national spotlight a lot recently, and not for the right reasons.
From the disappearance of Kelsey Schelling to the city's growing problems with gang violence and heroin, Pueblo has an image problem.
Now, new at 6 o'clock, KRDO News Channel 13's Carl Winder is asking what local leaders plan to do about it.
When it comes to Pueblo's image, the narrative in the national media goes something like this.
Blue-collar Pueblo has a reputation as the most dangerous town in Colorado.
The Denver Post says Pueblo has the highest murder rate in Colorado. The New York Times a month later says the homicide rate in Pueblo is higher than New York's deadliest borough. A dangerous image, but is it the whole story? People we spoke with say Pueblo has problems.
Kids that I don't think have any direction with their parents.
But that doesn't mean they don't love their city.
But I think Pueblo's great. I'd rather live here than Springs myself.
Right now the people have been really good and excellent to us.
Greater Pueblo Chamber of Commerce President Rod Slyoff says he can't control what the media reports, but he can control promoting what Pueblo has to offer.
We talk about all of the great things that go on here and all of the natural things that happen here, from the climate to the outdoor recreation to a great place to raise a family.
The Pueblo County DA says one way to improve Pueblo's image is by hiring more police officers.
If you want companies to come here from New York, Texas, or California, they need to know that they're coming to a safe community.
In Pueblo, Carl Winder, KRDO News Channel 13.
And despite the increase in gang violence, major crime was actually down in Pueblo year over year in 2015.
A local